Now we're going to enter the realm of matrix algebra. We're going to look at solving a system of linear first order equations. What does a general system look like? We have two variables, x1 and x2, functions of time. So we have x1 dot. We're going to do the constant coefficient equation, also homogeneous. That will be a constant A times x1 plus another constant B times x2. That's the first equation. If we do two equations, the second one will be x2 dot, and then some other coefficient C times x1 plus D times x2. These are two coupled first-order equations. The independent variable is t. The dependent variables are x1 and x2. If you know your matrix algebra, you know that you can write this then in matrix form. What would that look like? We've got d dt, and then we put x1 and x2 in a column vector. And that's equal to a matrix A, B, C, D, which is the standard 2x2 matrix, times the column vector x1, x2. So this system of linear first-order homogeneous equations can be written in matrix form, like so. If we like to write it more succinctly, we can just call this column vector x1, x2, we'll just call that x, and it's the time derivative. So each component has a time derivative, so I'll write that as x dot. And that's equal to a 2x2 matrix, which I'll write capital A, times the column vector x. So the system of first-order linear equations can be simply written as x dot equals a times x. To solve this, we're going to use an ansatz, and we're also going to use the principle of superposition. So we're going to look for solutions following our ansatz, and then when we find solutions, two solutions in this case, we'll multiply them by constants and add them together to get the general solution. So what is the right ansatz here? We're going to try x of t, the column vector, equal to a constant column vector, which I'll call v. So this is a 2x1 matrix, times an exponential, and we'll call that e to the lambda t. Okay? That will be our ansatz. And then we're looking for here, in this type of ansatz, we're looking to determine both lambda and v. What happens when we substitute into the differential equation? The time derivative, v is independent of time. The time derivative will bring down a lambda. Lambda is also independent of time. So substituting into the differential equation, we'll get lambda v times e to the lambda t is equal to a times v times e to the lambda t. As always, the exponential cancels. That's the point of the exponential ansatz. And rewrite this in a more telling fashion, put the av on the left, we get av equals lambda v. Those of you who remember your matrix algebra, this is the eigenvalue problem. So lambda are the eigenvalues of the matrix A, and v are the eigenvectors. How do you compute the eigenvalues? You use the characteristic equation, which is the determinant of A minus lambda I equals zero. This is a quadratic equation for lambda. If you remember your determinant of the 2x2 matrix, the A minus lambda on the diagonals and B and C off, this equation becomes lambda squared minus the trace of the matrix, A plus B D times lambda, plus the determinant of the matrix, A D minus B C equals zero. Okay, that's doing this determinant. And if you remember this from a matrix algebra course. Okay, three things can happen in a quadratic equation. What are they? The first one is that you can have distinct real roots for the eigenvalue, lambda. The second thing that can happen is you can have complex conjugate roots. And the last thing that you can happen is you can have repeated roots. Okay, should sound very familiar to the second order linear homogeneous equation with constant coefficients, because actually it's the same thing, okay, but looked at in a different way. In this course, we'll consider these first two cases, and we'll skip this third case, which is a bit too specialized for the time that we have to learn differential equations. Okay, so let me summarize. We're now considering how to solve a system of linear first-order equations. For simplicity, we'll consider two equations, an equation for x1 and an equation for x2. We can write it as a single matrix equation, or in compact form as x dot equals ax, where A is a 2x2 matrix. I'm going to show you how to solve this by the method of ansatz. We're going to try to find a solution for x of t equal to v, which turns out to be the eigenvector, times e to the lambda t, and lambda will be the eigenvalue. So upon substitution, you get the eigenvalue problem, AV equals lambda V. The characteristic equation for lambda is just the determinant of A minus lambda I equals zero. And because it's a quadratic equation, we'll have to consider, we could consider three separate cases. In this course, we'll only consider the first two. What does the solution look like when you have distinct real roots? And what does the solution look like when you have complex conjugate roots? I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.